Hello everyone, welcome to Athral Studio and this is Anuja. Today we will be doing a Pattachitra workshop, and I will be talking about a lot of the full figures and the sitting postures, different hand movements, how they can be showing. In Pattachitra, which is a traditional art from Orissa, we see that the side profile is mostly seen. So side profile means only the side of the face and maybe a twisted body or turned body. We will see that when we see the full figure, it's very curvy, it's highly curvy, and the waist is very thin and beautiful feminine bodies. Even for the males, we'll see broad shoulders, but the waist very thin. So that is what we are going to talk about and do it. So I welcome you all, and I hope you are getting my voice and video. So just a yes, so that I get the assurance, and we'll start. So what all stuff you will be needing, I will be briefing you. The drawing of the Pattachitra is done on a patta, which is a canvas made from the linen or the cloth. And we will be drawing it with normal pencil first. And generally it is drawn and then colored, and then the detailing is done by the brush directly. We will just do how we do the drawing of such figures. Okay, great. Thank you for a yes. And I will start. I'll place my camera on the workplace, and then we will start. Okay, so I've taken an A4 size paper, which is a 200 GSM. So slightly heavier, just a normal, not a printing paper. Do not take a printing paper if you want to do the painting. I get a lot of questions regarding whether we can take a 150, 160, 140. So there is nothing that you cannot take this paper, but depending on what you are going to do, it is decided how heavy paper you need. So if you are using full-on color or acrylic colors with water and full painting is painted, then you need a higher GSM, because then your paper will have those curls, so it will just get soaked in water. So if in case you are doing a very light coloring or just majorly the pen work, then you can take even a 140 or 160 GSM, that is okay. So today what I have taken is a 140 GSM, and I will be doing the figures which are in the sitting posture, and if time permits, we'll do the standing as well. So first, whenever you start a picture, I'll just raise the camera a little so that you get a full perspective of it. Yeah. So this is the paper. I want a seated figure right here. So at the bottom. And I will roughly take a circle for the face. And I'm doing it with the pencil very lightly, because these are not my final lines. So this is only the chalking of where I want my picture to be and how is the movement of the picture. Good afternoon, everybody. Okay, those who have missed the previous sessions, please don't feel bad about it. They are recorded and they are sent. So here what we have done is the Pattachitra workshop day one, where we did the borders and we know how to do the borders. Then we did the second day of the workshop, where we did the how to do the coloring of the borders. So first was getting the knack, then the colors. The third was how to do a side profile, side face and the front face of the Pattachitra. And apart from this, how to do the gods, the rishis, the demons too, for a story. Our day four was our Jagannath ji. The whole painting was done and painted there. Only the border was left for your desire. Whatever you want, you can do. Now today is our day five, and first we will study the figures, and then we will take up with the painting. So this is the face. So just a circle. Then you have to decide what is the movement of the body, whether it's straight, whether it's standing, whether it's sitting. So here I take the movement of the body, like this is the face, this will be the shoulder, and here is the waist, here is the body. So you'll get the idea of how I'm doing it. First, I'll start with the face. We have done very elaborate study before when we were doing the face study. So if any doubts on the face, you can have a look there. So here is the neck, then the shoulder on this side. The chest. Now we'll see how the body moves. So there is a very beautiful curve in the waist. This is how the Pattachitra waist of the body waist will be. I'll just lower it down for a better clarity here. Now so the foot here, and the posture of it is sitting with a leg folded. So I'm just giving a very rough idea of the figure. So here there is a lot of foreshortening. Foreshortening is when your limbs are showing a little angle and they feel short. They are not showing the full length of your limbs, like hands and legs. Sometimes when you are sitting in an angle, we call it foreshortening. So here is a little of the angle here and this. So here will be one foot, here will be another. So I'm just giving a very rough idea right now, no details at all. Details will come directly when we will ink it down. We'll put it with a pen. Now this is the Juda. Here I'll make the hands up and she is holding a pot on her head. So just I generally take one single line to determine what is the length, and now it will start. Generally this curve is there. When we'll do the final with the pen, probably it will be visible, and I will brief you on all the detail part. What is a what are the distinctive features of this? So we've got a very rough picture right here, and now I will start to do it with the pen. Okay, Rupa, if you've missed the third class, you can always check it on the YouTube. It is all posted. So those who are having exams and all, please, or busy schedule, any which way, you can just check it and do it at a comfortable time. Now, what pen I will be using is a waterproof pen. I generally use a Uniball. It lasts long, actually. So here we will do the detailing. Small chin, rounded face, these are very, very important. These are the features of this kind of a painting. Making the ear halfway, some design for the, and here is a big earring. Generally, the earring is kept as round. If in case any elaborate design is done, it is only the danglers that are added to the design. Few details. And I'm making a jura, that is a bun. You can have different designs on it. Like this. lower it down if in case it is. Probably we'll get the idea better. The neck is generally shown by these folds here. Now it gets really easy when you have a pencil drawing already. You just sketch it roughly and then you start doing your pen work, then or coloring. Then it gets easy for you to maneuver your design and actually enhance. If in case you feel that you can modify it, it gives you room to modify. This is the dress. We will see that when we are drawing the dress, we will not give that embossed kind of curve. Whereas when we are doing bangles and all, we will do the embossing of the curve here. Generally, there is a very different style of wrapping of the sari. That is, the drape is very different and the bust is covered with one cloth like this. And the other side is wrapped up like this. So this is the cover of the sari. Beautiful style of the waist. Sometimes we see that these curves are added. It may or may not be there. It is just the artist's point of view, how you want to put in the picture. So these curves on the side, which is on the bent side, not on the side which is extended. So this is a stretched side, the bending is over this side. So these will be added on here. Adding a belt, the foot here. Now I will be no matter. Now I've already plotted my other foot here, so I have to be very careful not to cross that because this is the one which is coming on top. This feature is very, very distinctive. Like whenever there is a line, we would have to curve it here. The same way we'll do it for the hands as well. The foot, there is a natural dip here. So this is how I have just made the foot. Some ornamentation. This is a kamarband. In Hindi we call it kamarband or the waistband. All these ornamentations are there and they have names for each ornament. So that is here. We'll make the folded leg. I'm adding the Now we have to go give gentle curve to find the foot nicely. And this is the anklet. When we make females, we see that there is one bangle kind of a thing, which is a hard one, ring-like, and one is the payal. So these are the two things that are there. When we are doing the males, you may eliminate this one, the second one. Giving the curve and the seat here, and like we did it here, we will do the same on this side, giving this cloth. This is the sitting posture. Now we've got all of it here. We will, the drape of the sari goes along this like this. Now these decorations, whatever the print, the detailings that you want to add on the dress, that is up to you, and you may add the more of the elaborate ornamentation. That is just one way of doing it. Here, coming on to the top here, first I will plot the ghada, what she is putting, the pot. So I'll just make a beautiful one, some nice pot. There. Here. And then I have to add the hands. For the hands, it is easy for us to do it now once it is done, because once you make the pot, then the hands, these lines will really show up. You don't want those borders to show. So you have to frame the hand. We also had Kalamkari workshop before. Those who have joined new will would not know about it. There's a Kalamkari workshop and we have dealt in detail how to do the hand mudras. We will talk about it in the tomorrow's class also, where we will do a little bit of the mudras, basically the hand movements while you're holding something, while it's open and twisted, whatever it is, the dancing poses and all. So we'll talk about how to do the hands. So here, and here. So now I will start to do the detail work. Here I'm adding some ornaments. So again, I made this kind of curve, which I did for the feet as well. This is very important when you are doing. Hands are generally thin, the fingers are generally thin. Now just giving the shape of the pot. These Pattachitra paintings can be very elaborate, like too much of details also, and you can minimize the details. That is also your way of doing it. So I have just did the outline. Now I'll be adding all the details that can be done, and you'll get the idea of how to do it. So the eyes are very nicely curved, like we call it the fish eyes. This is the same way. This is the eyebrow. If you have to add the details of ornamentation, you can just add a nut, and we will go ahead with the detailings. So starting from the top, just giving these curvy designs, like embossed metal has such kind of things. These designs are very common in Pattachitra. Just adding the scallop design everywhere. The details in the dress can be added by whatever prints you want to make. You want to do the overall design on the dress, or just small prints, that is your take on it. So here I'm not adding a lot of ornamentation, because I'm just making a lady who's fetching water. So probably not a very royal or Raja Maharaja or Rani or any royalties. I'm just making a general lady of those times in Pattachitra. Whatever ornamentation was done in those times, it was not clasped and it was tied up. So everything here will have a tie, whatever the design it is. So just make a drop and then curve. This is the way we will add the tassels. This is a very important feature. Like this. The same can be added over here, because this is also tied up. You can make different designs on these ties. Like in today's time also, we have those beautiful tassels. This is Now coming to the jewelry part. If your painting is really small, you won't have a lot to do in this little form. So then it is only the flowery design, like the petals. But if you are doing it a very big painting, then you will have a lot of room to incorporate new designs. I am still working. I'm working on a painting which will come as a video. And it's a very big painting in Pattachitra. Halfway done actually, but yes, it will soon come. And then you will be able to see what all designs can be put on the jewelry, what all different variants can be done, and how to create the shading in that. So that is very big, and we will do that in a video. So once it is complete, then you will get that as a full tutorial on jewelries and all. Framing procedure. Okay. Yes. Just to preserve the, one has a question how to preserve them and frame them. When you want to get any framing done, it is very important for us to check what material is being used at the back of the paper, because this is your paper. If you want your paper to be framed, be very specific whether they are putting a ply board or MDF or just a cardboard. It should not be very porous, as in like it should not absorb a lot of moisture. If at all, whatever they are putting, ask, you can always get one extra paper kept under it, which can absorb extra moisture if in case it is there. So this is one thing when I get my paintings off, I mean, especially the papers framed, I keep a couple of them at the back also. Sometimes these paintings get yellow from the moisture, which is only coming from the back. On the front, you can always cover it with a glass or an acrylic sheet. Now, choice of your double framing or single framing is up to you, how big you want it to be. But yes, do not miss on extra sheets at the back. The extra sheets at the back should be white, because if you use a brown paper or a newspaper, the print of it will get blotted on your picture. So be very careful about that, and then you can get that framed. So this is the way we can do detailings on this. I'm just adding a little bit of small tassel here of the hair, the curl of the hair, sorry, tassel I'm saying. This. I'm adding a little bit of hanging on the pile as well. Adding fingers, and this will give you a little bit of better look on this. So this is how the picture can be, and you can add multiple layers in it and do a lot of design. Now that is one thing that can be done as per your wish. This. Now I will be going ahead and showing you a standing figure as well. Okay, just by the side of it, probably we have some place here. Adding a little bit of water. So this is the place where we will add water, and here I wish to add a lotus. And a lotus leaf. And then just continue. You can have a couple of them because this is the place where she is sitting close to the water. You can have a little bit of movement in it, like twists and turns, and they're going on the other side as well. Not all of them, and some sizes variant can look beautiful. Thank you, Hetal. Thank you. You can add more water waves here, but at times we paint it. Now, probably in the next class, I will be telling you how to do the detailings and painting on this picture. Now we'll go ahead, though I feel that there is less place. We cannot do much on a standing figure here right now. We'll not get much place and it has to get overlapped then. So the standing figure we'll cover in the next class. Here how to add a little more different themes here. We can just add tree. So for adding a tree here, I'm making only circles. So these are the circles that will tell me that where the tree is, and here some ground where she's sitting, and here maybe another tree. So this tree is like a bush. There's a very different kind of trees. So we can just actually study more about the plants here because we do not have space of doing a full-fledged standing figure. We'll do that in the next class. So I can start with this as well. And there is one which will have such kind of branches and the leaves will be that like this. I'll show few here. Now the leaves that we make are very pointed and like this. There's always a stem attached to it like this. So this has to be like totally black, or if in case you are doing it in colors, you can add lighter dark green, whatever color you want to. The shading is also possible in this. And so I'm just going ahead and drawing these. So this is going both the sides, wherever the place is. Like this, we will just continue on both the sides to do the leaf. I'm just doing the leaf part. I'll add the stem, a little connection to the leaf that is important. So just connect it to the main branch. Thank you, Kavita. Thank you. Continuously, this is actually a little work that needs patience, because making those leaves in all the bushes, in numerous leaves, is actually a little work, and it won't get over very quickly, but that's why I'm just showing you a little variation on how we can add different kinds of plant. If in case we are not doing a god and goddess or sitting in a mandap, then, and if we want to make them in a setting of, especially when we do Krishna, Radha, we see a lot of background things like trees, plants, birds, swan, there's a lot that is there. So this can be done here. I must be connect all, and you can just black it out if in case you are doing a monochromic work, which is just black and white. You can do that as well. If you want to use colors, in that case you can use it in dark green. Now here these portions are there, Generally, what is done in this portion is, I'll just show you a quick. I haven't kept my colors here because I didn't plan about it. I'll just show you a little on that. I have a brush pen handy here. I'll just tell you a little. So, this is a place where I plan to do the maybe it's a bunch. Then taking a darker color, generally we have these darker shades on the top, on the sides, and I'm using a darker pen here. You can use your acrylic pens. It just came up because I don't want to do it black and white. I want to show you the other style as well. So this is what it'll come out to be. And I'll wait for the color to dry a little, and then I will tell you the variant that can be done in colors here. The same thing can be done in this part also. So I'm just using my brush pen to do the base. The same thing can be done with the acrylic paint, poster color, anything. So this is one bush over here. So I'll wait for a little bit time. I'll just give it a shade by adding little color on one side. This will all get mixed up when we will do the highlights on the top. Okay, here. So, it's blotting, it's spreading everywhere. You'll have to wait for some time to do that. Meanwhile, I'll show you the other parts. While doing this, the later what we have to do, I will show you here. It needs to be dried first completely. So when we are making a big tree, this is a tree where the leaf system is seen. Where are the bushes? It is very dense and we just make them like so. So just continue adding in a circular manner. You don't have to be very calculative as two are there, so the third one has to be in the middle. Don't think about that. Just keep on adding. It may have a little shift and that will look even better. Thank you so much for your comments. If you are liking it, press the like button. And those who have not subscribed, please subscribe. If you're liking the tutorials, share this workshop with others also who might like to add on. Arthral Studio continues to do free workshops on different art forms, and these workshops are not only tutorials, it will be full-fledged workshop where you will know the art form in about 8 to 10 classes or more at times. So it is a full course and all your queries, all your questions will be answered. I personally try to answer all of them. So if you have any doubt and it is being missed in the live session while I'm working, I might miss. So just, I'm so sorry about that, but you can write it in the comments and I'll get back to you. So So this continues, and it will take, if you are adding the background, it will take some time for you to work, because this is a slow thing that you have to cover. But this is the way the bushes of big trees are done. So if there is a tree and they have big bunches of leaves in every branch, then it will just, and they will be overlapping. So if at all you're making this one, it can hide a little on that. So it gives a very dense look. So this one, I'll show you one here. This will show you how it is overlapping. First thing is how it will look overlapping when you will color. This dark color will always stand against the light color, and then this overlap will be even more obvious. You can be a bit loose while doing the leaves. So even if it's not touching the end, that's okay, because we will be adding the light color also to give the look of it. The leaves can be big or small, like this. So you will see that it gets overlapped, and when it is colored, it will just show up beautifully. Now in the in this kind, so I'm switching on not to a liquid pen, I'm switching on to a gel pen now, so that it doesn't blend, it doesn't bleed on the paper. So we'll make the first one on the top. I'll just lower it down. So I'm making first one on the top, and thereafter I'm just going ahead like this. See to it that they are going downwards and not upwards. Again, try to make your lines loose and not sticking to each other. That gives a very beautiful natural effect. There are a few more shade patterns that I'll show you on the tree. I'll try to cover this lady as well in colors. We have some time. So here, and when we have to give the highlights on this, then we just give a little in the white. This gives you a very beautiful embossed look, and the visual appeal is very nice, and this is done in Pattachitra. So it's not that it's my discovery, it's there, and it's just, I just happen to do the same as it is. So these small white or probably light green, whatever color you choose, any lighter color, because that shows the shine on it. I am using a jelly roll white pen to do this. You may also use a brush and paint, acrylic paint or poster color, whatever your wish is. And again, you don't have to be very calculative. Some places you can do just dots, some places dashes, some places curves. That will give you the a little effect of how the tree is. It is not always very all the leaves are all in bricked up together. It's not like that. So just give that loose feeling here. The same thing here also. Once we do it, I will show you how to add the effects. Now already it's dried, and now my gel pen is not blotting against it, and so I'll just do my lines with the gel pen. You may actually use the brush, not the brush pen, but actually a lining brush, which are the fine liners, and but just to speed up the process, I've picked the pen. So here already there are two shades, light and dark, that will add up to the beauty of this bush. Plus I will be adding the accents with the white pen. So those highlighted portions will actually be even more highlighted. Like this, and now with this. You can also add them in white or yellow. Just making the V on the corner of the leaf. You can curve it, or you can make a V, whatever is comfortable. Just give one end where it's shining. Like this. So this is the form of how it... Yes, it's looking like the illuminated tree. Actually, it is like that. So when we do the pictures, when we do the painting, they really get lighted up and they look very beautiful. So this, I will be adding these two also later. I'll just give you a little detailing on this part. A lot of details are only done by the brush and the colors. So it is not always that we draw too much on this. So for the rocky place where... a little pebble ground or the ground, what is the main feature is we just do it like this. This way, not needed that you have to end it all together, and then few lines to show them. Small plants, if in case 1, 2, 3, already three of them are added, but what if we want to add some more here, then it will be just simple few lines like this and with the leaf. So these are very simple. This mostly it's seen vastly on different kinds of paintings. So you can just add a little here and there to just fill up the place, and the big painting will look bright and beautiful. So this way, here also maybe a few, and they will add up to the beauty. So don't be very calculative again on the bush, where the leaves are going, how many strands are there. It's about just filling up the place and how much dense you want it to be. The full color version will be provided to you. I will do the full of it and then I will share it with you. Because this will be colored blue and the lines will be covered with white. So that is how we would do it. What else? That's pretty much the picture is complete. So you all have a look at it, and drawing part we'll just finish it off, because the green part actually, and it will come out really nice. Yes, of course, you are there's no limit of adding details. You can add all the details. Any other question, if in case you have, you can write it down and I'll be answering it now, because I'm just details are totally your wish. Even for the picture, for the main figure, what is there, you can add as many details as you want. Okay, Bhavna. Even I'm happy. Thank you. Anybody has any questions, any doubts, please ask me. Or else later, please write it on the chat, or not on the chat actually, after it it's off, it will be only available as a comment. So write the comments and then I will get back to all the comments that you, all the queries that you would post. And this is how we will actually work on. Even when this is colored, I mean, like I did the drawing, I can add the color. And then again, the detailing on it. So this is not as difficult as it seems, but yes, it takes a lot of patience to do any artwork. But yes, the end results are always good rewards of and satisfaction on your artwork. And then after your base is painted, after your detailing is done, the next part is highlighting it with white or yellow, and that finishes your color part of it. So this is the picture. I will finish the coloring and I'll get back to you. You will get it as a tutorial about how to color it. Any questions? Thank you so much. Yes, the facial features were done in the previous class. I would link in the video that was done in the day 3, the faces when we did. So those who are having difficulty in doing the faces can refer to the day 3. Okay, so here I would just thank you all for being with me and supporting the channel also, and sending me your works. Yes, the best part is even the small children are sending me works that they followed the tutorial and did it so well. I really appreciate that. Thank you so much. And I'm very happy that you all are learning and I'm sharing what I know. So thank you for your time. And I will see you all tomorrow at 3 again. And we will do the detailing, the border of this picture. I will do it and it will be posted in a day or two. The border, the detailing, the background, everything which you will get as the tutorial. Tomorrow we will do a full standing figure, how the curves are and how the body movements are. So thank you. Thank you everyone. Bye-bye.